Hello guys, this is Pawan here again. Welcome to Embedotronics. So today I will tell you how we can interface one keypad. Let's say 4x3 keypad we'll use. So how to interface 4x3 keypad with 8051, and what we will just whenever we'll press the key using one 7 segment, we will display that particular number. If you guys are not following my tutorials, you just go to our channel and just see there 8051 tutorials are there. So we have started 8051 right now, and we will go to some other controllers as well. So by the time we starts with this, so just follow those tutorials and you will come to know a lot of things I have already taught. So now here we will start this keypad interfacing. Okay, so before I'll move to the coding part and all, just I'll tell you what is that keypad looks like and how the internal circuit of that keypad is there. So if I'll say normal keypad external things, so this is like a phone. We have a keypad phone. Initially we had this type of keypad in our cell phone. So this is just the prototype of that. So here you can see we have this numbering, and then we have star hash in the last row. So the same way one keypad you will take, and on that keypad this we will initialize this this thing will with R0, and this thing will with R1, and then R2, then R3, means row 0, row 1, row 2 and row 3. And same we'll initialize this thing C0, C1 and C2. So we'll connect these pins to controller, and we'll do the coding like that. Okay, so this is the circuit, this is the outer circuit of keypad. If I'll talk about the internal circuit diagram, how this keypad actually works, so let's move to that thing. So here you can see this is just our internal circuit diagram of any keypad. Here this is the thing, this is the prototype of 8x3 keypad circuit diagram, you can say 8x3 keypads. So here you can see in every key we have one switch, one push button is there, you can see. And how this push button is connected, you can see one leg of that push button is going to the rows, each row, and another leg of that same push button is going to each column. So here you can see, if I'll talk about this push button, it is kind of first leg is connected to R0 and another leg is connected to C0. Same way this you can say R0 and then C1. Same way all the push buttons are connected. So what is the thing here? If I'll press this, so whatever the logic I have given to this R0, the same logic this C0 will get. Obviously, if I'll press this thing, so this thing will be shorted. So whatever they will get to this point, so same thing we will get to this point. Same way every push button will work in same logic. So how I will do the coding of this keypad, means like how controller will come to know whether this key is pressed or this key is pressed or any key is pressed, suppose. So how controller will come to know, so that is the main thing. So for that, what will we do? We will just initialize these pins of R0, R1, R2, R3. Obviously these pins are connected to microcontroller, so we will just give one to all these pins. It means these pins are making, we are making these pins as an output. So because we are giving values to these pins, so that's why we are just making these pins as an output. So we will initialize these pins as one initially, and after that immediately if we want to check this switch, suppose, so we will say, let's say we are giving R0 equals to 0 now, as all the pins are, we have already given 1. Now immediately after that, we are giving R0 equals to 0. So what will happen? Then we will read this column, every column we will read. If we have given 0 to this point, so we will read every pin. How will we read? We read through one if condition. So if I am pressing this switch and this is 0, so if C0 is also 0, let's say, then this key is pressed. And if I have given 0 to this point, and if C1 is also 0, means I am reading this C1 now, so it means this key is pressed. And same way if C2 is 0, so this key is pressed. Same way if R1 equals to 0 and other rows are 1, and R1 I have given 0. Now if I'm saying C0 is also 0, if I'm checking that C0 is I'm checking the condition means status of C0, and if I am finding that it is 0, so it means this key is pressed, because how when it will get 0, this 0 is there, so when it is pressed only, then only it will get 0, because this when it this thing will be pressed, so this these two points will be shorted, and whatever the value is here, it will get the same value, will get this point as well. So the same way this logic will work. Let's move to that code itself so that we'll understand more better way, in a better way. So here you can see we have declared S bit data type for every pin. We are using port 1 for keypad. So what I have done here, I have just initialized P10. I've just assigned P10 value to R0 and then P11 value to R1. Same way all the pins are declared. So it means now R0, R1, R2, R3 is connected to the two P1's smaller bits, lower bits, and then column pins are connected to the higher bits till 6, because only 3 pins are there. So P17 we are not using, and here one function we have called, that is nothing but void seg unsigned int. So this function we will tell for 7 segment display, we have declared this function. Now if we'll go to the main function, see whatever the thing I was telling on that image here, the same thing we have done here. What we have done here, R0, R1, R2, R3 we are initializing with one value, and now I am giving R0 equals to 0, and I am checking the condition of every column whether C0 equals to 0. If C0 equals to 0, and if actually it is 0, so definitely we will call this function, because this condition will be true. So we will call this sec 0xf9. 0xf9 is nothing but the hex code for 1 in 7 segment display. If you guys didn't follow the means, like if you guys are thinking that how this hex code is coming, you should follow one tutorial where I told you like how to interface 7 segment display with 8051. Just go to that tutorial, you will see how this hex code we are generating. I'll put the link of that video in the description below, so that hex code you will get come to know. So for that, in short, I'll just tell you that this represents 1 in for 7 segment display. So if this condition will be true, so I will get 1 to 7 segment. And same way, if I am telling like again R0, R1, R2, R3 is 1, and as simply we are just giving row 0 to 0, and if column 1 is getting 0, it means now second key is pressed. So segment 0x a4 I am calling, it means this is the code for 2. Same way this thing, and here this is the code for 3, and now this is another case. Now we jump to the next row, and that is row 1. So now we are checking for that row 1, and row 1 equals to 0, R1 equals to 0 means, so if C0 equals to 0, it means 4 is pressed. Fourth switch, you can see here, this we are talking about this now. So if this is pressed, so we will just get this 0x99, which is the code for 4, and same way all the pins will work. We are checking every we are just assigning value to R1, and we are reading columns, every column we are reading. So whenever the any column's status, we will get 0, so we will come to know that key is pressed. So this way you can see here we have started with R2, R2 equals to 0, and again we are checking all the columns. If C0 equals to 0, then this will we will get this. This is 7 for hex code in 7 segment display. So these are the things you can see, and here you can see segment this sec function. You can see here we are passing this argument unsigned int ch. This ch is nothing but which is coming from this sec, this called function sec. We are getting here, and that ch we are just assigning to this P2 port, and through this P2 port that 7 segment is getting correspondence value. So now I hope you understand this code. Now we'll just compile and build this thing, this code. So you can see again rebuild this, so we'll get the hex value. Now just you can see hex file from key 11. Now we'll just move to our Proteus part. Here you can see We have this already this circuitry is there. We already have connected all the components for saving the time. Just I'll just upload this thing now. This key 11 was the hex value, so I'm just uploading it now. If I'll just run this thing, okay, so I have just I clicked this play button. Now if I'll just press any key, so that value I'll just see in this sound segment, because we have passes those value in that if condition. So if I'll just press 1, so I'm getting 1. Same way 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7, then 8, then 9, and then 0. So here you can see all the things we are getting in this sound segment. So hopefully you like this video. If you have any doubt regarding this thing, just comment us below, and please don't forget to like and subscribe our channel for frequent updates in this embedded system. And in the next tutorial I'll just tell you how we can get some that in same that 7 segment whatever value we are getting, same way for I want to get those value in LCD. So how those value we can just generate in LCD, that thing we will do. So till then, thank you guys, thank you very much.